Total poems, bunch of poems was on hate. I think the wet person come out of water. So it is transparent. And that kind of picture, it just float front of my eyes and I did directly.
But then here in this lithograph, you have almost the traditional image of Vithoba, except that you have made it a kind of a simplified geometrical figure rather than the cylindrical figure of Vithoba, arms akimbo and all that, which we see at Pandharpur.
Yeah.
But I've seen many other figures of Vithoba, including folk figures of Vithoba and Rakumai,
yeah,
in smaller temples throughout Maharashtra. And this has a striking resemblance to the actual figure,
actual
except
figure,
that this is a geometrical simplification.
Simplify.
But let me ask you the question. Now, you have used Vithoba in this form, but you have also represented Vithoba in forms like the one there in that painting.
Yeah.
Now, this one is not abstract. This is in a way representational because it represents the known image of Vithal. And that one is purely abstract.
It is the color blue. We were talking about the color blue. It's how we see the sky. So where it comes blue, sometimes I want to present the Vithoba in blue.
All right.
But there is connection, the Vithoba and the blue color.
I think this painting that we see is something which you say you were inspired to paint by one abhang of
Tukaram.
And I'll read that abhang in English translation and then ask you the next question. Where does one begin with you? O Lord, you have no opening line. It's so hard to get you started. Everything I tried went wrong. You've used up all my faculties. What I just said vanished in the sky, and I've fallen to the ground again. Says Tuka, my mind is stunned. I can't find a word to say. I've taken a slight liberty from the original Marathi. It's a slight liberty and it's a permissible kind of liberty. The original Marathi abhang starts with the line, Kahicha nalage adi avasana. So, which means that I don't know where you begin and where you end, O Lord. O Lord, I don't know what your beginning is and what your end is. Now, that's the opening of this poem. And Tukaram is expressing here his helplessness in describing God. He says, God, I can't describe you.
Yeah.
I just don't know how to begin to describe you and where to end the description.
So, I use the colors because Tukaram couldn't find the God.
He couldn't find the words for
words,
God.
Words
he
for
he the, found God,
yeah,
but he didn't find the words
for God. And I couldn't find the forms of the God. So, black color and blue color using in the painting, I think it was just impression for that abhang to put these colors and around the square, the which square I use for even the bhakta, standing bhakta.
Yeah.
And same thing when it goes differently, it could be the
Now,
Vithoba.
This is again the familiar image of it.
Familiar image of it.
But then, behind that, there is a painting in which we see the same Vithoba in a very abstract form.
Abstract form. Because the about Vithoba and his colors, the living colors. There I am talking about the living colors, the red, the magenta, the orange, I use in it, and wrote just the Vithal.
I think we can go on to the next painting that we have here. And this belongs to quite a different mood and quite a different setup, because the Abhang that you say you have been inspired by is an Abhang about the situation in Tukaram's family and his life after the famine. In fact, after the famine, during the famine, Tukaram gave away all his food grain and wealth to poor people, needy people. As a result, he himself was bankrupt. And his creditors came to ask for their money, their loans to him, which he could not pay back. And so Tukaram was disgraced as a bankrupted person.
Correct.
And had to hide his face in shame. Now he writes this Abhang, which I read out. And then you can comment on the painting and how the Abhang inspired the painting. It's all gone to rack and ruin. We are all down and out. Nobody claims us. Lord, you are in full spate. My home lies shattered. My very seat is destroyed. Says Tuka, O God, come closer to me.
This is really very difficult painting. Because when I was busy with it, I found the feelings of Tukaram, what would be that one? This famine,
ruins,
somewhere the bodies are burning, the black is there, the dots of blacks, somewhere doing the dashakriyas.
So is this something like a more or less semi-abstract long shot of the ghat of Indrayani?
Ghat of Indrayani.
All right.
So the lines, the blue lines,
are like a mirage.
Yeah.
They are more like a mirage. It's not water but mirage.
It is just like this. There is no water, but it fills water just. And that atmosphere, I feel, and how to get it, I was trying it. And when it finished, I thought, yeah, that was the dry land, the completely no grass. And that colors is dried, seems to be dried grass.
This is an Abhang in which Tukaram says that all the tragedies in his life were actually beneficial to him. It's a very strange way of looking at things, because he says that I'm glad that there were tragedies in my life. Each tragedy freed me from the bonds of my material bonds to an earthbound existence. My spirit was freed by each tragedy. And so, I'll read the poem. When my father died, I was too young to understand. I had not to worry about the family then. Vithu, this kingdom is yours and mine. It's not the business of anyone else. My wife died. May she rest in peace. The Lord has removed my attachment. My children died, so much the better. The Lord has removed the last illusion. My mother died in front of my eyes. My worries are all over, says Tuka.
This is actually the game between two persons. there are.
Yes, in Marathi, the word for kingdom that Tukaram has used is Rajya. Vitu, Tuze, Maze, Rajya. Ani Kanse Kaya Kaza. Vitu, this kingdom is yours and mine. It's not the business of anyone else. So, this kingdom, by this kingdom, Tukaram means the whole of existence. The whole of existence is divided between you and me. That is the divine and the human.
So, I tried to get that Tukaram's message, and what I feel was just his wife died. He burned his wife. The son died. The mother died. And there is just the blackness. The body is burned somewhere. But the line is there. One black line is there. And one circle. That suggests it is yours and my kingdom. We will play this game. Or we will see.
So as you see it, it is Vitthal who had given him the wife, the mother and the children. And it is Vitthal who has now taken them away. And so whatever Vitthal gives, Vitthal also takes away. He is the giver and the taker. And it's a kind of a game played between the two.
That's why it is in the circle.
All right. So you have tried to interpret.
But the color scheme and the shadows, the gray according the shadows and the black according to the death. Because I think there were no other colors.
This is actually ashen. It's the color of ash, the gray. And the black is, of course, like charred or burnt bodies, bones, or
anything like that.
Oh, I see. I'll read this poem. Oh, what kind of Lord are you, who remain beyond my sight, beautiful, lavish, blue, four-armed, graced by a single garland, a streak of musk on the forehead, holding a conch shell, a discus, a mace, wearing the Vaijayanti necklace, rings gleaming in both the ears. Says Tuka, O merciful Maya, mother of all appearance, Pandurang, show me your feet.
The image of Vithoba in this painting, I feel just make portrait of Vithoba. The colors is the blue, the purple in it. In Marathi, they say Ghaughavit Savala. Means the atmosphere should come there. So his turban with a red strip, his complete blue face, and the leaf on the forehead.
Is that a tulsi leaf? Or what leaf is it? It is a tulsi leaf by the traditional kind of traditional.
But they say Amruta Che Paan. And it suggests just his nose and the brown lips and the ring in the ear.
All right.
It is just a portrait of Vithoba.
I will now read a poem which expresses Tukaram's sense of peace, of bliss, of serenity. after having gone through various traumatic and sorrowful experiences of life, he is now feeling calm and liberated because he finds himself one with his deity Narayan. And this is expressed in one of the lines in this poem, in which he says that he has built his nest in Narayana, as though Narayan is like a tree in which Tukaram has built a nest, like a bird, and he's resting, he's at peace there. The night has passed. What sleep? I haven't seen it. I have built my nest in Narayan. My joy does not cease. I have compressed my space. I have no room for myself. Says Tuka, we are contained together. We do not split for one moment. Now I find that the leaf you had in the earlier painting is in a way repeated here, although in a different color.
Yeah, this is the Haiki painting. When I read the Abhang, I feel he is far away from the regular place in the way of thinking, and going to the Narayana's nest means it has to be complete light experience.
Yes, he says the night has passed. And what we see is the luminosity of yellow. And the yellow almost becoming white. At the center of this form. So then is it a leaf or is it a flame? Because a flame also has a shape similar to a leaf.
It could be the leaf, it could be the flame.
It's not an object, it's a form of light.
It's a form of light.
All right. Narayan is a form of light.
Light.
And Tukaram is settled into that form of light. Okay. I have been talking to Bhaskar Hande about his Tukaram project. And this is a project which has not ended. As I said earlier in my opening remarks, it is an ongoing process with Bhaskar. 200 paintings will not exist the potential of Tukaram. In the process, what he has done is something unique. He has taken inspiration from one of the greatest poets of India, an Indian language poet. And inspired by his work, he has done paintings which he has been exhibiting in Europe along with the poetry that inspired it. So whenever he exhibits these paintings, you have a printed version of the poem in English and in another European language accompanying it. This generates a lot of discussion among people. His viewers, people who normally visit galleries, see this quite a unique, exciting and unusual thing, that an Eastern person, a person from the East, a person from Asia, a person from India, speaking a highly developed language and literature, which is not known in Europe. The language Marathi is not known in Europe. The language Marathi is not known in many parts of the world as a language. Although it's a major language, to us, it is not known in Europe. Now, these people get introduced to the idea that there is great literature in India. And that this literature is so great that it contains poetry that can inspire a contemporary poet, although that poetry itself was written 350 years earlier. So they see that there is some kind of a seed of modernity within the Indian tradition, that if it found the right soil, can even sprout and grow in the 21st century. And this point is made by the Tukaram project of Bhaskar Hande, that we can be inspired by our own tradition and we can stand up as contemporaries in the modern world, and the world will respect us for being what we are. We don't need to imitate others and their traditions and their own achievements. We are not doing any art, whether it is poetry or painting, second hand. We do everything first hand.